such as the United Nations Security Council, the World Bank and the IMF. Existing problems cannot be solved effectively without a greater voice for developing countries on issues such as global trade, finance and development. Mr. Chairman, developing countries can be drivers of global growth. International financial institutions should therefore be encouraged to fund infrastructure development in the developing world in more innovative ways. We should also urge that the current economic crisis should not lead to a dilution of development assistance flows from the developed world to the developing countries. While we come together on the international stage, it is equally important for us to collaborate among ourselves in tackling problems and developing solutions that are best suited to our own circumstances. For example, the developing world is rich in renewable sources of energy like solar power. We should use our financial and intellectual resources to develop renewable energy technologies that get less attention in the industrialized world where the resource base is different. Adoption of these technologies will also enable us to contribute to preservation of the environment. We can learn from each other in this effort. Similarly, food security is a basic problem for many of our countries. Excessive speculation, structural bottlenecks, and a lack of coordination are fueling food inflation at the global level. Our movement should push for effective food policy coordination and cooperation at the global level in areas such as growth of agricultural productivity, weather forecasting, and research and development. Perhaps most relevant for us is to focus on investing in the knowledge economy and building our human resources.